Hello and welcome to Bloomin' Great Books.
Today we're sharing our 6 top quarantine reads, all picked for pure escapism.
Looking for a quirky read in quarantine? Listen to our chat on the convenience store woman.
And God, it's so inspiring. I mean, you know, the joy that she gets and in doing her job well and having that routine and that system, I think all of us can, I think that resonates with all of us. And with me, I sometimes think, you know, when I'm in office jobs and things, like sometimes I was never happier than when I was doing bar work or waitressing. Okay. You could do a great job, you could exceed expectations, and then you're done and you can leave it. Whereas a lot of our jobs are constant and you never feel like you finished and you never feel satisfied. And actually, maybe she's achieved real success because she is proud of herself and she is fulfilled every day by doing these mundane things really well and throwing herself into it.
And I think that this idea as well of like it being mundane and, you know, isn't everyone's job like an element of, there's an element of mundane every single job, and there is always parts of your job you find more boring. And how amazing that she didn't really view any of her job boring. She literally was like, and how upset she would get when she went into a different convenience store and they weren't upselling, you know, the food on sale. It was just so good because I feel like actually, and that this is another thing that I think which they did really well, which maybe taps into this idea of success. When I was reading it, I was thinking, how is she not manager of like multiple stores? Like she knows everything. She is on it. Yeah. She's very quick to change things when they need to be changed. So I think that's a clever undertone as well. That actually she could have achieved more. She was better than the one job that she had, yet she was happy with the job she had. That's why she stayed.
Yeah. I mean, well, also, you know what it's like when you've got a gorgeous little coffee shop or something and then they get successful and they make multiple chains and they're never going to be quite the same as that little one that was on the corner. So maybe she's more, you know, the most enlightened out of all of us, really.
Just
understanding her place in the world. And, you know, it comes back to that thing we were saying with Alan de Botton and that bravery in the mundane and in mediocrity. Mm-hmm. And actually, if you can come to terms with the fact that you're not super special, you're just what you are, what joy and fulfillment can come in life just by being.
Yeah, just by being.
Do you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Loved it. A really good